research learns from the past. The dye library really is a priceless collection of dyes. About 98,000 dyes is our estimate, that were custom manufactured over a period of about 50 years. The benefit of this donation to us, it's at a treasure trove of information and data that has never been published, has never really been accessed outside of a very small group of scientists and engineers at Eastman. And it came as a result of Eastman's relatively new Center of Excellence, a partnership between NC State and Eastman Chemical. In addition to the dyes, there's a tremendous amount of dyed fabric material and testing data, thousands of samples, hundreds of thousands of samples, in fact, that are going to be useful to us in our research in multiple areas, from forensic analysis of dyes, we're developing a database, to the development of new dyes for solar panels, for improvement of dyes for the application to textiles, plastics, hair, paper, packaging, you name it. In material science, Dr. Frank Hunt is interested in developing dyes with infrared absorption signatures that can be helpful in camouflage protection, for example, to prevent military personnel from being detected from night vision goggles. There is a growing area of dyes research in the development of dyes for cancer treatment, where the dyes will actually be designed to dye cancer cells and not healthy cells. And that allows us to be able to identify the cancer, but also by shining a tunable laser onto that area, the dye will absorb the energy of the laser and kill the cell. So this is a form of targeted chemotherapy. We can build on that knowledge, it's not lost. Too often happens is research is not fully reported, particularly in industry, and Eastman has had the foresight to bring their technical expertise to the public through NC State for the common good.